everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and strangely, today Apple released iOS 14.2 Beta 1. They skipped 14.1, and maybe they're going to push that out with iPhone 12 next month, and then 14.2 later, or it's hard to say. Maybe we'll get 14.1 this coming week or even tomorrow at the rate Apple's going. So I'm not really sure exactly what Apple's doing with this, but this did come in at a very large 4.42 gigabytes on my 11 Pro Max. Now, anytime there's a beta that's going from a regular public release to a beta, it's going to be a very large file. It's going to fully install that update. And so it's on my 11 Pro Max. I also installed it on my 12.9 inch 2020 iPad Pro. So let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and then take a look at what's new. And you can see the build number is 18B5052H. And that H means, well, we're a ways away from the final version, which usually ends in an A before it's released to the public. So we sort of count backwards down to A. So we're a ways away, and maybe we'll see it in October around the launch of the iPhone 12 or something like that. Now, there's a lot of changes that have to do with music. So the first one has to do with the lock screen. So I have my iPhone XR here with iOS 14 on it. If I go to the lock screen, so I'll turn the phone off, turn it back on, and you'll see the lock screen. Let me go into music here and try that again. There we go. And you can see on the lock screen, music looks a little bit different if you have it playing. So you can see the album art is a little bit bigger. We've got the song name scrolling, and that it'll scroll on the other one as well if it's longer than what will fit, but also the AirPlay icon is a little bit different and smaller. So they've changed this around just a little bit. Now, if we go home and go to the music app, they've changed that as well. So if we go to the music app, you'll see here's a song that was playing. If we tap on the AirPlay icon, they've changed the way AirPlay looks. So again, we'll check on iOS 14 and you can see what it looks like side by side. So iOS 14 on the left, 14.2 on the right. So that's a little bit different. Now they've changed it in the control center as well. So if we pull down in the control center and haptic press or 3D press on the song or the music icon, you can see that the album art is much larger on 14.2. It has the song underneath and the controls below that. So they've changed it. The AirPlay icon is below that as well. And instead on iOS 14, it was on the right. I think it looks a lot better on iOS 14.2. Now, also, if we tap on the AirPlay icon here, you'll see it looks a little bit different as well. So again, AirPlay looks different. Now there's also an additional button if you have AirPlay devices connected to your network. So I took a screenshot of this so I could show you. And actually, this is from a viewer, Kieran, that sent this video to me, and it's a little better representation of what it looks like if you have connected devices. It says control other speakers and TV. And so that's in the control center. And then also, if you're in the control center and maybe you don't have music playing, let's close it here. And then we 3D press or haptic press on the music icon, we get suggested songs to play as well on the control center. So this is all new with iOS 14.2. On the left, we just have our music. We can hit the play button. There's nothing new there. Within the control center, there's a new option for music recognition. So if I scroll down, you can see I have an icon and it's the Shazam icon. So I can turn that on and it immediately turns on the microphone. You know that by the orange dot. And you can add that by going into your settings and then control center, and you'll see it down at the bottom. If you don't have it, you just add it. You can remove it, of course, if you don't want it. Now, this listens for music until it hears a sound. So it's kind of interesting. It doesn't seem to turn off by itself. And if you pull down in the control center again, it says music recognition. So let me play a sound or a song and see if it will recognize it. Now, right after I played the song, it popped in with a notification and told me what the song was. And then it turned off the microphone. So you actually have to go back in and turn it on every time. So I guess it's handy if you want to use that and then just clear it off your screen when you're done. Now, thanks to Matthew Heber for sending along the next one. There's a new headphone safety option under sound and haptics. So if we go into settings, then we go down to sound and haptics, you'll see it says headphone safety. Now, it's sort of a renaming of a different one from the previous version where it said reduce loud sounds, but there's a lot more options in it now. So reduce loud sounds had one option to reduce the sound, but now we have headphone notifications and last 6 months, and it will let you know and keep track of that. And then also reduce loud sounds and turn up or down the decibels. So it's telling you that 80 decibels is about as loud as a noisy restaurant. If I slide it up, it says as loud as city traffic, as loud as a motorcycle, car horn, and so on. So we can turn that on or off if we want, and then it will notify us via headphone notifications. So let me show you that Twitter account again so I can show you what it looks like. And thanks again to Kiernan. This is what a notification looks like when there's loud sound. So it says, based on your headphone usage over the last 7 days, the volume has been turned down to protect your hearing. So it will actually do that if you turn it on. Of course, you could turn this off as well. Now, also to do with the headphone notifications, if we go into the Health app, tap on Browse in the bottom right, then we go to Hearing. Under Hearing, we scroll down where it says no data available for me. There's headphone notifications and there's some more options. I don't have that on iOS 14. So there's no data available. It's just more options for hearing and health data based on your headphones. So it's really nice that they've added that, and it's just a little addition. Now, there's also a couple other small changes. So for example, the Apple Watch icon has been updated. So if you go to the Watch app itself, you'll see the Watch now has that new solo loop on it. Where before, if we go to Watch, you'll see with iOS 14, it looks a little bit different. It had basically the regular silicon buckle that it came with, or the sport loop. So they've just updated it to be more with the newer bands that you can get for the Watch. Now, the first time I went into the Watch app, when I went in here and then I went down to hand washing, I actually got a new notification pop-up asking if I wanted to share data with Apple regarding hand washing. So it says improve hand washing. You can help improve hand washing by sharing some of your data with Apple. You can stop sharing at any time in settings, and then you can share it or don't share. And so now you can have them collect this data if you want to, or not at all, of course. So it's up to you. It's an option, but it's something new that they've added. And that's everything that I could find new, along with the help of Kiernan and Matthew. Thanks very much for that. Now, there are no additional updates with the iPad. So iPadOS 14.2 basically gets the same thing, but no additional updates. So nothing really has changed there. But there are 4 known issues with this particular beta, and they may be significant to you. So the first one is, if you're getting a new 8th gen iPad tomorrow or today, by the time you're watching this, that's not supported. So you won't be able to get support for that. So you can't install the beta, maybe later with beta 2. And then also Apple Cache Family isn't available in this beta. So if you're using that, don't install the beta. And then finally, in iOS 14.2 beta 1, you cannot send audio messages using Siri. So if you're using Siri to send audio messages, it won't work. Now, there's no mentioned resolved issues, but one thing I did notice is my shortcuts in my control center for all of my home devices have reappeared, where they sort of disappear based off location on iOS 14. You'll see here on the left. So it seems like they've fixed that with this beta. And then also Apu Borakua, if I'm saying that properly, if not, I apologize. He said copy and paste is working properly now. So it looks like it's being fixed quite a bit with a bunch of different bugs. Now, Apple did not specify any bugs that were fixed. So hopefully there's a lot of them in this. Now, battery life overall is hard to say because iOS 14 has only been out a couple days, but I can tell you what it's like for iOS 14 GM, and hopefully it improves with this particular update. And it takes a few days to measure that. But if we go into settings, go to battery, my battery health is at 95% after almost a year. 80% after 2 years is normal. So the updates don't reduce your battery health. They just check the physical capability of your battery. And if we take a look at my battery life, well, let's take a look at it yesterday. It was not great. Or 2 days ago when I installed iOS 14, you'll see 6 hours and 41 minutes of screen on time, 7 hours and 1 minute of screen off time. I think I have an app using it in the background, but I was pretty active on Twitter and I need to turn off some of those notifications, but that's almost with 100% battery use. So that's pretty terrible for me. 10 to 12 hours is normal and I haven't had time to let it normalize. So hopefully this update will be normalized over the next couple days and we'll know how it is. But in general, I'm not sure what to expect as far as battery life. And should you install iOS 14.2 beta 1? If you're just looking for stability at this point, I would say skip it, wait for a few betas. If you really want to try out the new features and music, then of course go ahead. Now, as far as performance, I noticed immediately that it seemed to be very smooth. There's just a different animation feel overall to it. It just feels snappy, smooth, going through different apps seems nice. And there's just something to it. Even with the iPad, it felt smoother to me in general. I don't know if they've changed something specifically. but it's hard to say. Others have said they've changed the font. I did not see a font change, so I don't really see anything there. Maybe you do in different applications, but I don't see it personally. But that doesn't mean Apple's not working on something with that. Now, as far as Geekbench scores, I did run a Geekbench, so let's see if I can find that here. I scored 1,336 for single core, 3,176 for multi-core. Now, I ran this right after I installed it, so I would expect it to get a little bit better. That multi-core score is not great, but the single core is quite good, so it would probably go up if I ran it again. I did run it on the iPad as well, so let's take a look. And you can see on the iPad, it scored 1,127 for single core and 4,640 for multi-core. So quite good. Again, let's go to the history and see what we got with iOS 14. And we got a little bit higher for multi-core, but less for single core. So in general, it's pretty good. I would expect similar performance at this point. And now we're just looking forward to iPhone 12 and additional devices. Now, if you've found anything else, let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. And of course, I'll have a follow-up on Sunday with iOS 14 and maybe this beta as well. Let me know if you want to do a follow-up on Sunday with this beta in the comments below. So that's it for iOS 14.2 beta 1. Now, I would expect another beta in a couple weeks, maybe a final release of iOS 14.1 within a week or so. It's hard to say exactly what Apple's doing because they haven't told anyone. So it's a little bit up in the air at this point. iOS 14 just came out to everyone, so maybe we'll see a public release sooner than we think. But other than that, that's really all there is with 14.2. So I'll keep you updated. If you follow me here on YouTube or Twitter or Instagram, I'll update you there as I know what comes out and what's new. So if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.